The death of young rugby league player Jack Kedsley is once again raising questions about how to keep our kids safe playing sport. But as Andrew Denny reports, others argue there are no ways to guard against tragic accidents.
To say rugby changed Ben Robertson's life is an understatement.
And it ended up everyone falling on top of me, and that's where I blacked out. Next thing I knew, I was flat on my back looking at the sky.
17 years ago, his spinal cord was severed when a maul collapsed on top of him in a schoolboy match.
Anything that can improve the game or in the safety of the game is good.
In a contact sport as hard-hitting as rugby league, size matters.
It's a shoulder charge.
The NRL has been trialling junior matches where players are grouped by size and weight, not age. It follows the death of 16-year-old Jake Kedsley at the weekend. He was knocked unconscious in a tackle and never woke up. Today, schoolmates raised money for his family and laid more flowers at his home ground. Jake's death has sparked calls for improved safety standards, including making headgear compulsory.
But experts who've studied headgear for 2 years say it's not the answer and it doesn't protect players from life-threatening injuries.
There's no evidence that headgear is going to prevent head injury in any of the football codes we play in Australia.
The NRL's trial of weight-grouped junior teams continues. Andrew Denny, 10 News.